When performing the trim to roof or shell command, a so-called trimming body is used. The View, On-Screen View Options, Trimming Bodies menu command toggles the display of trimming bodies. When displayed, they are shown as red transparent bodies. Roofs and shells can have trimming bodies, since these can be trimming elements. When we are trimming an element to a roof or a shell, what we are actually specifying is whether the part of the element within the trimming body should remain, or the part outside of the trimming body should remain. The trimming body can be thought of as an SEO operator. If we click the lower part of the wall, the trimming body works as an intersection SEO operator. The wall works as target, and the result will be the intersection of the wall and the trimming body of the roof or shell. If we click the upper part of the wall, the trimming body and the physical body of the roof or shells together work as a subtraction SEO operator. The wall works as target, and the result will be the body of the wall minus the trimming body and the physical body of the roof or shells. So the essential difference between an SEO operation and the trim to roof or shell command is that in the case of SEO, the physical body of the element is used, while in the trim to roof or shell command, the trimming of the body of the roof or shell is used in the operation. If we trim roofs and shells to each other with the automatic method, what we can see is that those parts of these roofs and shells will be removed that fall within the trimming bodies of other roofs and shells. This is the default way of operation. This is important because the location and position of the trimming bodies of roofs and shells can be changed in their settings dialogs. We will see more of this in other Intelligent Connections videos.